ago, 1914 to 1918, the World War One, the Great War, took place. 16 million died and a further 20 million casualties. In this documentary, I will be exploring the battlefields and memorials in Flanders Fields. So, we're going to take a tour of Flanders Fields in Belgium, and the first stop is Wladslow German Cemetery. Yes, we are here at the Wladslow German Cemetery, 1914 to 1918. Yes, well, it is about 3 kilometres northeast of Wladslow. Established during World War One, the cemetery holds 3,233 wartime burials. In 1956, burials from many smaller surrounding cemeteries were concreted in Wladslow, and now contains the remains of 25,644 soldiers. Each stone bears the name of 20 soldiers, with just their name, rank, and date of death specified. So you can see that there's a lot of gravestones here, and each one contains 20. The cemetery also contains a pair of statues, the grieving parents, a noted German sculptress. She made the statues in 1930s as a tribute to her youngest son, Peter, who was killed in October 1914 and is buried nearby. The eyes of the father gaze on the ninth stone before him, on which son's name is written.
And in this trench there is a picture. My sweet children smile at me, and in this heart an endless longing, wherefore are those smiles I see? Black as the sun, black as the sun. Snow, won't you chill my wings? Spring, she has come too soon. Fire scorch as we retreat, and flesh decays around my feet.
We're here at the Trench of Death in Duchemwitz in Belgium. It's called the Trench of Death because underneath they buried the dead bodies immediately under the trenches, and that's why it's called the Trench of Death. This are the Belgium trenches, and this is where they fought the Germans. That is the river there, what they flooded, the Belgians flooded to stop the Germans from doing anything. Very clever idea. Now here are some footage of the trenches and some trench songs what the soldiers sang while in the trenches. Enjoy!
To live with any luck inside a trench, your nose must be accustomed to the stench of the rotten bush that lie on the parapet and die, 'cause they make a smell that hell itself can't quench. Keep your head down, Fritzy boy. Keep your head down, Fritzy boy. Last night by the pale moonlight, we saw ya, we saw ya. You were mending your broken wire when we opened with rapid fire. If you want to see your Vaterland, your Vaterland, keep your head down, Fritzy boy. If the sergeant steals your rum, never mind. If the sergeant steals your rum, never mind. Though he's just a bloody sot, you must let him have the lot. If the sergeant steals your rum, never mind.
Oh, never mind.
Far, far from wipers, I long to be where German snipers can't get at me. Damp is my dugout, cold are my feet, waiting for whiz bangs to send me to sleep.
Pack up your troubles in your old kit bag and smile, smile, smile. While you've a lucifer to light your fag, smile, boys, that's the style. What's the use of worrying? It never was worthwhile. So pack up your troubles in your old kit bag and smile, smile, smile.
Raining, 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 always bloody well raining, raining all the morning, raining all the day, grousing, 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 always bloody well grousing, grousing at the weather, grousing at the pay.
They're the trenches of death, and there were some of the songs they sang in the trenches. We're now here at St. Julien Memorial. The memorial commemorates the Canadian 1st Division participation in the Second Battle of Ypres of World War I, which included the defence against the first poison gas attacks along the Western Front. Frederick Champin Chess's sculpture, The Brodering Soldier, was selected to serve as the central feature of the monument following a design competition organised by the Canadian Battlefield Monument Commission. So it's a Canadian monument. So what you can see here are bunkers, and they were used during World War I. And there's a picture of them in the earlier stages. Here are a couple of pictures from, this is the Essex Cemetery where we are now in the past. And there it is again. So Essex Cemetery, Essex Farm, Ypres, has It has 1,204 dead commemorated, of which 104 are unidentified. And again, there are lots of Irish buried here too, as we see in Tycott Cemetery coming up later in our documentary. So here is a boy who was 15 when he died in V.J. Strudwick, the Rifle Brigade, on 14th of January 1916. He died at the age of 15. He was just one of many who lied about their age to go out for the adventure.
The date was June the 7th. The time was 3:10 a.m. Nightingales were singing in the woods.
Then suddenly the whole earth heaved, and up from the ground came what really looked more like two enormous cypress trees, the silhouettes of great dark cone-shaped lifts of earth up to 3, 4, 5,000 feet, and we watched this, and then a moment later, of course, we we struck the repercussion wave of the blast, and it flung us right away backwards.
The whole hillside, everything rocked like a ship at sea. The noise from the artillery was deafening. The thunder from our charges was enormous. The infantry dashed forward under a barrage and went forward and kept sending back thousands and thousands of prisoners.
Over 7,000 German prisoners were taken at Messines. Men shaken and unnerved by the huge explosions which had swallowed up many of their comrades. In one concrete shelter, four German officers were found sitting round a table, killed by shock. For miles around, it seemed like an earthquake. It was distinctly felt in London. General Plumer's Second Army had won a clear-cut victory. April, Vimy. In June, Messines. The two strongest bastions of the German front had been stormed by the British army. All the omens seemed favorable for the great offensive. Breaking out of the salient seemed to be only a matter of time and preparation. The army trained and labored at the massive build-up required for a set-piece battle in 1917. They were in good heart. They did not know that ugly clouds were gathering about their enterprise.
Stop is Hill 60 in Ypres. 17th of April to the 7th of May 1915 took place in Flanders, south of Ypres, on the Western Front during First World War. Hill 60 was captured by German 30th Division on 11th of November 1914 during the First Battle of Ypres. The ground south of Zéret rises for 2,000 yards to a ridge between Zathring and Zandruvum. Roads ran northwest to southeast through the area from Ypres to Verbatenmolen. The Ypres railway ran roughly the parallel roads. So literally, this blew up and where the German bunkers, Belgium blew them up, and you could feel them vibrations from London. So it was one of the biggest bangs, biggest explosions, now not including the nuclear explosions. What you can see here is a German bunker, and you can just see, it's just about covered, but you can still see in it. So that would have been totally clear in its day. So this is Hill 60, where a big bang blew up. Belgium built trenches under the bunkers and blew them to pieces. So that's a German bunker, what you can see there. You can just see all the little hills and little things. That's been the mud what blew up, so it's scattered all over the place. And you can just, you can kind of tell when you walk into this place that that is the mud just splattered out. So the Hill 60, it's very important. So you can look it up too to get more information on Hill 60. So here are some more pictures. There's the digging trenches. Now we're here in Flanders Museum in Ypres. So we're going to go in and have a look around and see what there is and just show you a bit what is in the museum if you don't get to go. So here is around Flanders Museum.
If you want the Sergeant Major,
I know where he is, I know where he is, I know where he is.
If you want the Sergeant Major,
I know where he is, he's stealing all the private's rum. I've seen him, I've seen him.
the private's wrong. I've seen him, I've seen him, stealing all the private's rum.
If you want to find the CO,
I know where he is, I know where he is, I know where he is.
If you want to find the CO,
I know where he is, he's down in the deep dugout. I've seen him, I've seen him, down in the deep dugout. I've seen him, I've seen him, down in the deep dugout.
If you want the old battalion,
I know where they are, I know where they are, I know where they are.
If you want the old battalion,
I know where they are, they're hanging on the old barbed wire. I see them, I see them, hanging on the old barbed wire. I've seen them, I've seen them, hanging on the old barbed wire.
Now when I was a young man, I carried me pack, and I lived the free life of the rover. From the Murray's green basin to the dusty outback, well, I waltzed my Matilda all over. Then in 1915, my country said, son, it's time you stop rambling, there's work to be done. So they gave me a tin hat and they gave me a gun, and they marched me away to the war. And the band played Waltzing Matilda as the ship pulled away from the quay. And amidst all the cheers, the flag waving and tears, we sailed off for Gallipoli. And how well I remember that terrible day, how our blood stained the sand and the water, and of how in that hell that they called Suvla Bay, we were butchered like lambs at the slaughter. Johnny Turkey was waiting, he'd primed himself well.
In Flanders fields the poppies blow, between the crosses, row on row, that mark our place. And in the sky the larks, still bravely singing, fly, scarce heard, amid the guns below. We are the dead. Short days ago we lived, felt dawn, saw sunset glow, loved and were loved, and now we lie in Flanders fields. Take up our quarrel with the foe. To you from failing hands we throw the torch. Be yours to hold it high. If ye break faith with us who die, we shall not sleep, though poppies grow in Flanders fields.
So we're now here in the Menin Gates in Ypres. This is a Commonwealth remembrance for all the people who are lost or missing. Commonwealth nations except for New Zealand and the Newfoundland for the missing. There's 54,896 people. So what you can see there is a wall, and that is a protection wall. So protection from, you know, from the, it's for the army. So there are, yeah, so there's 54,896. So they're the walls of the Menin Gate, and there's names written on all them walls, and there's Irish names too. So the Menin Gate is a war memorial in Ypres, Belgium, dedicated to the British and Commonwealth soldiers who were killed in the Ypres salient of World War I, and whose graves are unknown. The memorial is located at the eastern exit of the town and marks a standing point for one of the main roads out of the town that led Allied soldiers to the front line. Designed by Sir Reginald Bloomfield and built by and maintained by the Commonwealth War Commission, the Menin Gate Memorial was unveiled on 24th of July 1927. That was the last post there. And what you're looking at now is one of the many battlefields which took place in Ypres. So we're now going to Tycot Cemetery. Tycot Cemetery, 1914 to 1918, holds 11,954 burials, of which 8,367 are unnamed. I'll now go through, country by country, the deaths in World War I. Australia, 62,081. Canada, 66,990. India, 74,191. New Zealand, 18,116. Newfoundland, 1,570. South Africa, 9,516. United Kingdom, 1,012,075. Irish, 30,304. Belgium, 144,337. France, 1,737,800. Greece, 176,000. Italy, 1,243,400. Japan, 4,661. Montenegro, 13,325. Portugal, 89,222. Romania, 665,706. Russian Empire, 3,394,369. Serbia, 495,000. And United States, 117,465. Austria-Hungary, 2,081,200. Bulgaria, 187,500. German Empire, 2,800,720. Ottoman Empire, 2,825,000. Denmark, 700. Luxembourg, 300,000. Norway, 1,180. Sweden, 800. They are all the people who fought in different countries in World War I. This is Tynecott Cemetery, which holds 11,000 burials and much more around Flanders Fields. May we never forget those who died in World War I. I hope you have enjoyed this time and learned lots of things with me during this Flanders Fields documentary.
Jimmy's gone to Flanders. His fiddle lies upon his bed. It was his father's fiddle, though he's aye been shy to practice it. Jimmy's gone to Flanders, his fishing creel's a tangle fae the nicht. He and Willie fished the Eden, though it was nae moon. Jimmy's gone to Flanders, he's spiled the old dog rotten with scraps below the table, though I told him time and time again. Jimmy's gone to Flanders, his fit bobbits are sodden for the snow. Been near Dublin since he bought them new from Sandy Broon. When Jimmy's in the Flanders, he'll be shamed to clean the football boots and sort it all untangled for the end that he it's fishing good. When Jimmy's in the Flanders, we'll be sat by the table and we'll cook some tea as fiddle. Jimmy gives the bon islanders. Jimmy's gone to Flanders, though he had a job at Logie's yet, but all the lads were jining, it'll all be owed by Christmas time. Jimmy's gone to Flanders, though he's no the strength his father was, I'm sure he'll be worthy, and the jockey would they burst with pride. When Jimmy's in the Flanders, he'll be shamed to clean the football boots and sort it all untangled for the end that he is fishing good. When Jimmy's in the Flanders, we'll be sat by the table and we'll cook some tea as for dough. Jimmy gives the bon islanders. Jimmy's gone to Flanders, and again he has a lassie. Her feathers saw them walking by themselves below the falls of May. Jimmy's gone to Flanders, he's as secret as his feather was, but I caught her weeping as the sergeant marched into the train. When Jimmy's in the Flanders, he'll be shamed to clean the football boots and sort it all untangled for the end that he is fishing good. When Jimmy's in the Flanders, we'll be sat by the table and I'll coax and tea his fiddle. Jimmy gives the bon islanders.